wala ay ano. Aayaw-ayaw na ako, ngunit yan ay di totoo. Dahil sa iyo, puso kong ito'y binihan mo.
This is Focus on Your Health. It's brought to you by Kingman Regional Medical Center in historic Kingman, Arizona. I'm T.G. LaFredo, and on this week's program, a Philippine radio journal. We're taking you on a trip to the other side of the world. I have traveled to Manila with my wife, Dr. Lyanna LaFredo. This is her homeland. She's traveled here to visit family and to attend her sister's wedding. I am here to capture some of the sounds of the place. I've packed a couple of $1,000s worth of recording gear for this journey. My overwhelming preoccupation has been getting this stuff into and out of the country. I'm not smuggling drugs, I just have mics and cables. But in the Philippines, the rules are different. You never know when a low-level bureaucrat will seize your equipment, citing some made-up statute. That's just what happened to a friend of mine. Years ago, he traveled to Boracay to work on a documentary. The crew got in and got their footage without a problem. Leaving the country was another story. Airport officials essentially stole their gear and held it for ransom. I told my wife this story. She said she believes it. She also said it was a long time ago and the government has worked to end that sort of corruption. Let's hope. You can't talk about Manila without talking about traffic. The traffic is staggering. It's stupefying. By comparison, the 405 in LA during rush hour is peaceful and relaxing and easy to navigate. And the root cause of the traffic problems is overpopulation. In fact, overpopulation is the root cause of pretty much any problem you can name here. Hunger, poverty, crime, pollution, insufficient health care. Consider these numbers. The Philippines is an archipelago composed of 7,107 islands. The total land area is a little under 116,000 square miles. By comparison, the total land area of Arizona is about 114,000 square miles. Now, the population of Arizona is 6.7 million. The population of the Philippines, over 100 million. Imagine Arizona with another 93 million residents. Or think of it this way. The United States has about 319 million people. And again, the Philippines has 100 million. So imagine 31% of the US population crammed into Arizona. Here's a closer look at the Philippines by the numbers. And Dr. LaFredo, you're here to help with this.
Sure, let's do it.
In my research for this program, I happened upon a website called ifitweremyhome.com. That's where I found the following statistics. If the Philippines were your home instead of the United States, you would die 7 years sooner.
Be three times more likely to die in infancy.
Make 91% less money.
Spend 99% less money on healthcare.
Use 96% less electricity.
Consume 95% less oil.
Be 84% less likely to be in prison and be 2.4 times more likely to be murdered. And finally,
if the Philippines were your home instead of the United States, you would have 81% more babies.
Yeah. And yet, I don't want this to sound like an indictment. Filipinos are wonderful, and that's not just an afterthought. If you have Filipinos nearby, you have friends nearby. They're generous, they love to share, they love a good meal, they love a good song. In so many ways, these are my people. but they're a lot more sociable than I am. Well, for as long as we've been going to the Philippines, I've wanted to go on a jeepney ride. And before we take our radio trip on the jeepney, we have to talk about what a jeepney is. Can you help me with this?
The jeepney is the most widely used form of public transportation in the Philippines. The jeepneys are privately owned, so the jeepney drivers own the jeepneys themselves. It's iconic. I guess the Philippines is kind of proud of it because it's you could find it nowhere else in the world. It's they were originally U.S. Army jeeps left behind after World War II, and it represents Filipino ingenuity in the sense that people just made a few modifications so you're able to seat more people.
Lots of people.
They
cram them in.
And then use that as a form of public transportation.
Now, you said it's public transportation, but to clarify, it's not like public transportation as we know it. I mean, it's hard to find a printed jeepney route or a schedule or, right? I mean, it's kind of crazy.
Yes, it's not for the uninitiated. you would know, I mean, you know, there's no website where you go to and it tells you, okay, this jeepney has this route. You know the route because someone told you that, and then from experience, like riding the jeepney itself.
Unload out. Three kilometers.
So here we are, my first trip in a jeepney, and I've recruited my brother-in-law, Jan, to come along as a fixer.
So Jan, we're on our way, we're on a jeepney ride over to PGH, which is Philippine General Hospital. Yeah. And you're accompanying us today. And why is that? You're kind of doing security detail with us.
I'm gonna watch out for reprobates, trying to do something, you know, not exactly legal. I'm responsible for the fare too. I'm gonna be the financial advisor today.
I've wanted a jeepney ride for a long time, and every time I mention it, people say to me, "Oh no, don't!" You know, people will try to steal your stuff. They'll try to take your money. And now I've got microphone and radio gear with me. Is it as dangerous as people say?
It is. There's a lot of stigma around if you're in your Metro Manila or a crowded place. It is very very dangerous. So you have to be extra careful. You have to be more vigilant. But back where I come from in the province, it's not exactly that dangerous. But it depends on the location.
Really. Did you ever have anyone try to pick your pocket or anything like that?
No, it's all in the dress. It's all in how you wear something. I remember when I was a kid, I was walking down at 12 midnight because I was very thirsty and I wanted soda. So I was walking down in a very dark street, but I was only wearing some slippers and shorts with no pockets, and I kept my money in between those my tights. So it won't be obvious, and nobody touched me.
Right. So if you have tactics, you're probably going to be. If you have tactics and you're aware of what's going on around you, you feel like you're probably going to be okay.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Hide your. Sometimes you have to take some sort of a initiative, like hiding your money inside your shoe, something like that.
If you're busy messing with your cell phone and you kind of go to sleep as to your surroundings, that's when you are probably putting yourself at risk.
Yeah. You have to be more. You have to be alert at all times. Yeah.
We are nearing Philippine General Hospital. I've been here before. The lines are long. People come from all over to see a doctor. It's a government hospital, so the services cost nothing, and it takes time to get in. But they don't turn anyone away. On my first visit, I saw the people lined up out the door, down the street, around the corner. Things can get pretty crowded in here. I just did a head count, and I realized that there are 17 people in the jeepney right now.
Yeah, and it's not even full yet.
So how many people can you stuff into one of these?
This is a big jeepney, so probably
at least 26. And then, you know, that's if everyone's seated.
If they need to fit more in, how do they do that?
You can have people stand and ride, I guess, shotgun, do you call that? Mm-hmm. I don't know.
And I've seen people hanging off the back while it's going in motion, right? Now, just now, a couple of little street kids jumped into the back. We're at a stop.
Donations. He's singing, and he gave us envelopes before he started singing. So it's more of, if you appreciate his singing, you can donate money.
Time for a quick break on Focus on Your Health. When we return, a visit to Philippine General Hospital. And later, fun with Pinoy Radio. Stick around. And welcome back to Focus on Your Health. I'm T.G. LaFredo, and this week, a Philippine radio journal. I have traveled to Metro Manila with my wife, Dr. Lyanna LaFredo. This is her homeland, and I've brought some radio gear to capture the sounds of the place. We're just arriving at Philippine General Hospital. This is where she did her training as a young med student.
Well, so this is the OB department, so we're all, you know, pregnant women who needs to be delivered go. So you could see a lot of their husbands waiting outside, because husbands are not allowed inside. So the pregnant women go in, get registered, get checked out, and there's a labor room and then a delivery room in there.
You spent a lot of time in there?
Yes.
You delivered a lot of babies in there?
Yes. It's a busy hospital, so.
Is this the place where you delivered your first baby?
Yes. My first and my second and my third.
Do you have a memory of the first baby?
The first baby I delivered was, I delivered not in a delivery room, but in the labor room because mother couldn't wait. She was close to... She just had one big push and the baby started coming out. I saw the head and I had to do what I had to do to deliver the baby, I guess. Some residents or doctors, what they did was put their fingers in the vaginal canal to kind of stop the baby from coming out. But I didn't do that. The baby's coming out, so I had to come out and then delivered the baby right there. And then
successful delivery?
Yeah, it was a healthy baby. So when we wheel the mother into the delivery room, it's just to kind of cut the cord and transfer the baby to the nursery, which was just adjacent. And then and I had to stitch the mother up afterward.
So we've touched on the population of the Philippines.
Yeah.
Tell me about a busy night in OB here.
We see at least, I don't know how many, we see at least 10 deliveries a night. And that's on a good night, because you can get more. Yeah. Usually, I don't remember the average now. My OB rotation was such a blur because it was busy, so.
Our tour continues, and we make our way down to the emergency room.
So this is the ER. We see a lot of patients. We saw a lot of patients here. And it's usually, as you can see, it's, you know, inside the ER, it's divided into sections. The main sections are the adult medicine, and then the pediatric medicine is on the other side. You can see there are a lot of stretchers filled with patients. And these are patients that have already been evaluated by the doctors, and they're just waiting for, you know, for a bed up on the wards. The wards are always full. This is a government hospital. Medical care here is free, so a lot of patients who can't afford to go to private hospitals come here. So we're always swamped. And so all these patients here in the ER are probably, they've been here for days. And when if you notice when we pass through, there are several patients who are on ventilators, and because there is no room in the ICU. So they had to be, you have to kind of stabilize them and take care of them in the ER while waiting for a free bed.
What is it like for you now to walk around on this campus all these years later?
Well, it brings back a lot of memories. And, you know, memories I'd rather not do over, basically.
Some of them are good, I imagine.
Only when I look back, you know. But it's not something that, because it taught me something, but it's not something I would like to re-experience.
Does the place feel any different to you, or is it just like the last time you left it?
A lot of the things are the same. There are a few changes, like the looks like they've air conditioned the OB department and parts of the ER, but it looks like a lot of rooms here have been air conditioned, but I don't remember air conditioning or a lot of air conditioning when I was rotating.
We make our way to a new building that wasn't on the campus when my wife was a student. So do you gather this is a ward?
Yeah, it's a. It looks like it's an orthopedic ward.
So a couple of things that stand out to me. One, of course, you can see right in.
Uh-huh.
The other is there are no private rooms.
There aren't any private rooms, except for we have a small section in the middle of the hospital that's for private paying patients. But if you are for generally all patients here would have to stay in wards. And it's a given. There's an understanding that you won't get privacy. Sometimes we'd have to do procedures on patients with no... I mean, if we could find a barrier, we would, but sometimes there aren't any. So you just do what you have to do. And, you know, the bed neighbors, I guess, could see what you're doing to the patient. Sometimes some of them are really like, you know, catheterizations and things like that.
It occurs to me in our visits to the Philippines that there are a lot of places where you can be in a thoroughly modern place, in a hotel or in a restaurant. But if you really want to get a sense of, what am I trying to say, when we're here at a government hospital, it definitely feels like the third world.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And that's a big part of the country. It's, you know... concentrated areas, you'd have really nice places that could compare to the States, but if you leave those areas, then you would really see what the real Philippines is.
Yeah, how the rest of the people live.
Yeah.
I confess. This is super geeky of me, I know. But my favorite aspect of traveling is not lying on a beach, not shopping, or whatever it is tourists do. I love listening to the radio. Across the US and around the world, I love to see what the locals are listening to. Thanks to the internet, you can catch radio from around the world.
but that doesn't compare to actually being there. And listening to Manila radio, standing in front of the window, looking down on Manila traffic below, this is the best thing in the world. English, Tagalog, Ilocano, the maudlin love songs, the political talk shows, the religious blather, even a great rock station, Jam 88.3. And then there's Bombo Radio.
It's a news network. It started out as one station. Several cities have their own local stations. It's low tech. There's not a lot of production involved. Bombo is the Tagalog word for bass drum. I think that's how it started. There was one guy who had an old drum, or maybe it was just a tin pail or a bass. Yeah, it doesn't sound good. They give the news. After every headline, they punctuate it with this untuned drum. It's news and commentary. Sometimes they have a punchline. It seems like the drum punctuates each sentence.
Right. A guy on Bombo Radio is sort of like the town crier.
Right.
Yeah. So it's boom, boom, boom. Hear ye, hear ye.
Yeah, exactly.
Here's a little clip of what the actual Bombo Radio sounds like.
Pwede ka naman makabili anytime. Na mga binibenta po doon sa gilid-gilid ng kalsada na imported na prutas. Yan ang epekto po ng import liberalization. Ngayon, hindi lang po bawang ini-smuggle o dagay ini-import. No? Malalaki nga, subalit wala naman pong lasa. No? Kapag nagsasangga ako, hindi kasi yung malaki. Yung isang bilog na bawang, kulang, mga kaibigan. Hindi lang po bawang, pati yung mga iba pang agricultural products.
At some point, I was listening to Bombo Radio and recording, and I caught a Bombo health alert. Have a listen.
Bombo Health Alert! Watch out for the next Bombo Health Alert! Dito lamang sa Bombo Radio Philippines, ang pambansang radio ng Pilipinas. Basta Radio! Bombo! Bombo! Hanay Pilipinay!
Well, we do health and wellness on the radio, and so I started thinking it would be fun to put together Bombo Radio, Kingman, Arizona. Before we do that, I should mention, when we were in Manila, I needed to play the drums. So I found a little rehearsal studio and went there one night to work out. I took a recorder and a couple of mics, so what you'll hear on our edition of Bombo Radio is the floor tom from a Gretsch Catalina Maple drum set recorded in a little rehearsal studio in Makati, Metro Manila. To me, that's really exciting.
Yeah, whatever.
Okay. Well, it may not excite you, but I think it's incredibly cool. Travel the world, capture the sounds, bring them back, right? Here's Bombo Radio, Kingman, Arizona, featuring your brother, Boss Jan Yuchongtain.
Lead the children our future.
Di na mabilang kung ilan, ngunit ganun.
Day by Day Ministries sa pakikipagtulong.
Identified our main spiritual duty as citizens. And that is to pray for and respect those in authority.
Once there was a love deeper than.
Pero ang kalabaw ay nahanap na ligtas.
Ito ang pinakamagandang panahon para sa mga inyong anak para magpa-check up at para makuha ang mga kailangang bakuna. Huwag nang hintayin ang pasukan sa eskwela. Unahan ninyo ang lahat. Tawagan ng Diyos sa 3 Pediatrics ngayon sa 928-681-8706. Inuulit po namin, 681-8706. Tumawag na ngayon.
This has been a Bombo Health Alert.
Well, Dr. LaFredo, there it is, a sonic collage from your homeland, the Philippines. Thank you for being a tour guide for us and for giving us this little window into your culture.
Well, thanks for your interest.
My thanks to the good people at Philippine General Hospital. Thanks to Bombo Radio Philippines. Thank you to the folks at Ninoy Aquino International Airport who did not confiscate my recording equipment. Big thanks and much love to the Yuchongtain family. Special thanks to Anne, who got the Carabao home to safety, and to Jan for his voice talent and personal protection. I'm TG LaFredo. This has been a lot of fun. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. If you'd like to write to me, I would love to hear from you. My email address is foyhradio@gmail.com. That's Focus on Your Health. foyhradio@gmail.com. A hearty salamat for listening and magandang gabi.
Unahan ninyo, oh man.